good direction, socially at least. We've moved into more of an accepting society. There's a lot more equality.
We're completely divided on the things that we believe.
Everyone seems to be believing that they are entitled to something, so we have entitlement programs that cost a lot of money and that really don't help our country.
I see people who have decided that they want things more than they want freedom.
A lot of people take for granted how lucky we are to have what we do have.
I think generally as a whole, we're still headed in the right direction. We still stand for freedom and goodness in the world.
There's no way we can recover from $15 to $16 trillion in debt now.
We may have some potential problems in the future we'll have to check ourselves on, but
we are definitely in deep doo-doo.
I don't know, it looks sketchy if we go over that fiscal cliff. I don't know what I'm talking about.
What if Obama can talk to all these bears and rabbits, in which he can rule them just by talking to them?
I'm Matthew Pettit, broadcasting Pioneer Vision.
Thanks, Matt. That was informative. Decisions that state made in the election affect all of U.S. And now for a school announcement. The Germans Club Christmas Feast is Tuesday, December 18th at 2:30. This is open to everyone, so if you'd like to have German chocolate and hot dogs, pay your money to the financial office by December 12th. The first 25 to pay only have to pay $1.
Country superstar Colin Ray is flying into Utah to do a concert at Riverton High School on December 11th at 6 p.m. Tickets are $20 and can be purchased online through Riverton High School's website. 100% of the proceeds will go to local families of disabled children to buy wheelchairs and other needed supplies. This will be an amazing concert. If you have any questions, talk about tickets, talk to our own Miss Harrison in room 140.
The French Club is taking all interested students to the opera. Buy your tickets now and give them as Christmas gifts. Tickets are only $8 for students and $10 for adults. This cost covers transportation and parking. Buy tickets before January 4th, and the opera is at the 17th of January. You know you love me.
I know you care.
Just shout whenever.
And I'll be there.
And you are my love.
You are my heart.
And we will never,
ever be apart.
Justin Bieber fans, I'm sorry to tell you that someone has beaten your man.
That's a good thing.
PSY's hilarious video, Gangnam Style, has made more money than Justin Bieber's video, Baby.
Whoa! Weston, so in celebration, we wanted to see how I got their Gangnam Style on.
Gangnam Style by South Korean rapper Psy has officially become the most viewed video on YouTube. Have you seen the viral music video Gangnam Style?
Oppan Gangnam Style, yeah, I have.
No, I'm not into viral music videos too much.
Too mainstream.
I think it's Gangnam Style.
Well, I think it's Gangnam Style.
I disagree.
Yeah.
It's Gangnam Style.
Let's look this up.
Can you please do the Gangnam Style dance for us?
Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op. Oppa Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op. Oppa Gangnam Style. Hey, sexy lady. Op, 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 op. Oppa Gangnam Style.
It's a dumb video. I don't like it. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we know that it's raining money in Gangnam. We have Cindy Liu, who in the studio, to give us our weather forecast. Cindy, it is still foggy outside.
It is still very foggy outside, but as you can see, our snow is finally coming in this Saturday. Also, guys, don't forget that Dance Company has their Grinch performance on the 13th, and it's one can to get in. It plays at 6 and 7. Thanks, guys. Send it back to you.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, what?
I've noticed that the weather's been really stupid lately, but the Grinch performance will not be.
Hey, buddy. I feel ya. I really do. And this weather is horrible.
Well, me and Logan just had to go figure out what is wrong.
You know, that's right. I keep on saying that.
I'm going. Okay. Dee 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 dee. Dee 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 dee. Dee 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 dee. Dee 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 dee.
La da da da, a re di di do, la 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 la.
Hello, Lehigh. What's now is proud to be. It's December 4th, holiday seasons. Except there's one thing wrong with this picture. There's no snow. Do you see this, Lehigh? No snow. It's all grass. It's yellow. It's disgusting. We need snow. But don't worry, we're still doing things to bring holiday spirit around here to Lehigh, Utah. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping. And I brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow. Okay, we're here with Jake Rasmussen. Jake, how do you feel about the lack of snow?
I feel terrible.
Feels terrible.
I just want it to snow. Snow's wonderful.
That's how he feels.
Holy crap.
All right, we're here with James DeVore. James, how do you feel about the lack of snow?
I love it. Oh, well, hey, I love snow.
So you're sad?
Yeah.
I'm sad too.
It's okay, buddy.
All right, we're here with Adam. Adam, how do you feel about the lack of snow?
I wish we had it because it would feel more like Christmas, I guess.
Amen to that. Okay, and we're here with Chad. Chad, how do you feel about the lack of snow?
I don't know. I mean, I kind of want to go, like, sledding and sloshing or whatever it's called. But can't really because there's, like, no.
Well, that was very interesting, if you ask me.
I know, dude.
And now it's time to open our minds, Lehigh, and take a look at some top stories and making headlines in our world. Dre has our world in a minute.
Center for when the clock struck 12 to light up. Ghana elections are boasting with five people peaceful elections under their belt this year while they decided a new president. An Australia radio station played the ultimate prank on the hospital where Kate Middleton is being treated for her morning sickness. The reporter pretended to be the Queen of England with a horrible fake British accent and obtained information about her sickness. Now the hospital is considering legal action against the Sydney Australia radio show. That's a wrap. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Drea. There's a fun event coming up with more festive activity. Let's check it out with the student council.
Stu.
How are we gonna get the star on top?
I got it. Hear that?